Hi, this is JB from Now the Lights Over Arkham. This time we are concluding the run through the return to the Night of the Zealot with Stella and Winnifred. And we are playing the starter deck investigators and using the starter decks with upgrades that we have earned playing the previous scenarios. Let's quickly look what upgrades we took to the decks. First up, we have Winnifred. So again, I used the adaptable to change some cards, so I removed the two switch plays cards to add two pickpocketing cards for Wini. I've found out previously that pickpocketing is really good for Wini because she's doing a lot of evading and needs cards for the skill checks that she wants to commit a lot of cards to, so that's why pickpocketing is in the deck. I also upgraded one of the Mausers to level 2 and removed both of the level 1 Mausers and one slip away to add two 41 caliber Derringer level 2s into the deck, so that Wini has better weapons to fight in this scenario. So that is all the changes made to Winifred's deck. So let's see what upgrades we put in Stella's deck. So Stella upgraded both of the Look What I Found cards, and then I also added two flares to the deck and removed two Grimm's Fairy Tales, because I found that the Grimm's Fairy Tales were not that useful. And flare is really good in this scenario, because if everything is going bad and we have to appease Umordhoth at the end, we can try to find Lita to throw to the wolves. So that's why flares are in the deck, and they also double as extra weapons to defeat enemies with 3 health or less. But other than that, the deck is the same. In the previous deck list I posted in the last video, I noticed that I had 2 copies of A Chance Encounter instead of 2 copies of A Test of Will that are included in the Stella starter deck, so I corrected it into this video. I hope that didn't mess up anybody's deck list viewing, but that's enough of the deck. So let's go to the scenario. So we are playing the Devourer Bellow in Return to version, so we have more Arkham Woods locations that are picked randomly. Also, the ghoul priest is still alive, so he's somewhere in the encounter deck. And we have 2 cultists remaining after the Midnight Masks. We have the Bradley Cooper, Billy Cooper, not the actor Bradley Cooper. And also we have the Masked Hunter. So those 2 cultists will make an appearance some way through the scenario. And that is it. So let's see how Stella and Winifred do in this scenario. Let's get started. I have pre-shuffled all the decks, so let's start drawing with Winifred. And because we ran out of time in the last scenario, both investigators have to discard 2 cards at random at the start of the game. So we draw up to 5, then discard 2 random cards, which will slow us down. Winnie drew both of the weaknesses. Let's draw again for those. So we get Quick Thinking, Lonnie Ritter, Lucky Cigarette Case, Derringer and Daredevil. I'll keep the Derringer and Lucky Cigarette Case, and I think I'll mulligan the rest. So we get Streetwise, Anything You Can Do Better and Daredevil. And we'll shuffle these cards back into the deck. Okay, and then we draw Stella's cards. So we get both of the Look What I Founds. I think I'll keep one of them. I'll keep the Flare and the Derringer and Mulligan these two. So we get Take Heart and Grit Your Teeth. Let's shuffle these back into the deck. And start playing, so I think the first action for Stella is to play the Derringer. Oh yeah, before we do anything, before I forget, we have to discard two cards at random from each investigator, so let's shuffle these up and discard two. Okay, so we'll discard these two. So we lost Take Heart and Grit Your Teeth. So we can still play the Derringer. Oh yeah, and the objective is to get 6 clues so we can advance. And we have one Doom on the agenda because there's 2 cultists remaining. Second action, let's move here with Stella. So it's one of the new locations, it's the Lakeside Forest. After you reveal a Chaos token from the Chaos Pack while investigating this location, reveal and resolve an additional Chaos token with one per chest. There are 2 clues here. And last action, I'll investigate with Stella. We are investigating 2 versus 2, so we have to reveal 2 Chaos tokens. So the first Chaos token is -1, and the second one is a cultist, and the cultist is -2. Place 1 Doom on the nearest enemy. There are no enemies in play, so we fail, and we can actually play the Look What I Found because now it's upgraded. So fast play after you fail a skill test by 3 or less. While investigating, discover 2 clues from any amongst your location and a connection location. So I'll play the Look What I Found and grab these clues. And we get an extra action because we failed a test. So last action, I'll just move back here. And that is Stella. Stella's turn done. We go to Winnifred. We should have discarded cards earlier. Let's do it now. See what we lose. So let's discard that one. We lose the Daredevil and we lose anything you can do better, which is really bad. But yeah, I think we'll just set up Winifred to do some fighting, and we'll play the Lucky Cigarette Case and the Derringer. So the Derringer has 3 ammo on it. And last action, I think I'll just play down the streetwise. No point in moving blindly anywhere at the moment. No enemies, we go to upkeep. We draw a card for Winifred and Stella. And we gain 1 resource for both. So that is the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a Doom to the agenda. We are at 2 of 4 Doom. Stella's encounter card is Frozen in Fear. I will use a test of will for the test, so we test willpower 3. If you succeed, cancel that revelation effect. So let's see how we do. We are testing 4 versus. I think Winifred will help out and commit the 3 of aces to the test, so we are testing 5 versus 3. And unfortunately it's a -5. If there is an ancient one enemy play, reveal another token. So we are not able to cancel the Frozen in Fear, so it comes into play. Winifred's card is Rotting Remains. We test Willpower 3 with 1. I have nothing to commit to this test, so 1 versus 3. It's an auto fail. Well, we take 3 horror. That really sucks. And nothing we could have done about it. And that is the Mythos phase. We go to the Investigation phase. I think Stella could start. Actually, let's start with Winifred. So Winifred moves here. So it's the Arkham Woods old house location with 2 clues. This location is investigated using willpower instead of the skill in the pick by the investigation attempt. So we'll just move back and reveal another location. And we reveal Twisting Paths. It's a tree shroud location with 2 clues. When you move out of this location, test the knowledge intellect tree. If you fail, cancel the effect of the move. Okay, so I think Winifred tries to investigate there next turn. But Stella moves to the old house. And in, it costs 2 moves because of Frozen in Fear. Also, we failed a test, so we get 1 action extra, which I forgot earlier. So we'll just investigate here using willpower. We are testing 3 versus 2. It's a minus 3. We'll use the extra action to investigate again. So 3 versus 2. And it's a plus 1. So we get 1 clue, and that is the turn done. We'll test the Frozen in Fear. 3 versus 3. It's a minus 2, so we don't get rid of it. We go to upkeep, no enemies. Winifred draws Reckless, gains 1 resource. And Stella draws Rabbit's Food and gains 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 3, Doom of 4. Stella's encounter card is Disciple of the Devourer, farthest empty location. And after you spawn Disciple of the Devourer, you must either place 1 Doom on it or place 1 of your clues on its location. If the current agenda is not agenda 1, do both instead. So we just place the Doom because we are at the witching hour. So it doesn't matter at all. And we'll let's put it here because we're not we actually we can just put it here. We need, don't need to care about that disciple anymore. Winifred's card is Umordhoth's Hunger. Revelation. Each investigator must discard 1 card at random from his or her hand. Each investigator who has no cards in his or her hand is killed. Heal 1 damage from each enemy in play. So, because this isn't a hidden card, it can be discarded at random. So it gets discarded. And we have to randomize which card we discard from Stella. So we lose the Rabbit's Foot. And that is the Mythos phase, so Investigation phase. I think we start with Stella. So we investigate twice. We investigate. Oh yeah, and investigate doesn't cost extra action. So testing 3 versus 2. And it's a minus 5. We fail. So we use the extra action granted by Stella's ability. We investigate again. Minus 3, we fail. Let's investigate again. I know there are some easy tokens in the back. Well, there's zero. We get one clue. So we have four of the six clues needed to advance. Last action. I think Stella will draw a card. Because we don't have enough moves to move. Actions to move. So we'll test Frozen in Fear. I'll commit take card to the test. We're testing 3 versus 3. It's a minus 1. We fail. But we draw 2 cards. We get the Daring Terror and Rabbit's Foot. And we gain 2 resources. And Frozen Fear is still in play. Let's go to Winnifred. I think Winnifred will just investigate 3 versus 3. It's a minus 2. We'll investigate again. Minus 2. Well, I'll use the 2 resources to investigate for the last time. 5 versus 3. It's a plus 1. I'll use the lucky cigarette case to draw a card. We get the lockpicks and we get one clue from here. And that is the turn. Enemy phase, nothing happens. Upkeep. We draw a card with Winifred and Stella and both gain one resource. And that is that turn. We'll go to the next turn. We are at 4 Doom of 4. So we advance the agenda. So, death to the intruders. Shuffle the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck and discard cards from the top of until a monster enemy is discarded. Spawn that enemy at the main path, then place one doom on that enemy. Okay, let's shuffle the discard into the counter deck first. Okay, we discard cards and, well, we get the Yithian Observer. It's a monster Yithian. 4 fight, 4 health, 3 evade. Prey, fewest cards in hand, forced. When a Yithian Observer attacks you, discard one card random from your hand. If you cannot, Yithian Observer deals plus 1 damage and plus 1 horror for this attack. And then we get the encounter cards for this turn. So Stella's card is Mask of Umordhoth. It attaches to this guy and it gains one doom and a loop and then and also 2 health and then Winifred's card is well this sucks. Well that guy is nigh unkillable now, so I think we just have to ignore it. It's not good because now there's 2 doom in play and nothing really we can do about it. So I think I will first so I think I'll start with Winifred. I'll commit momentum and lockpicks to the investigation test. I'll draw a card. I'll get nimble. We are testing 5 versus 3 for the investigation. We get a skull, and a skull is X is the number of monster enemies in plane and it's 1. So we succeed, and we succeed by 1. So for the next skill test we get plus 1 from momentum. And we get this clue. So we'll advance. So Put the set aside ritual site into play if it's not already. Play search the collection for each enemy recorded in the camp log under cultists who got away and spawn those enemies into the main path. So, I totally forgot about this. So, we get Billy Cooper and the Mask Hunter to the main path, which will not be good. So there are quite many enemies there now. And we get the ritual site in play. We'll just put it here. And connection token. So I think Winnifred moves here. All of these guys engage Winnifred. And I think we will try to kill off the Yidian observer. That way we get rid of Billy Cooper. So I will use the Derringer. I'm shooting with 3, 4, 5, and 6 from the momentum. So 6 versus. Four. It's a plus one, so we actually succeed by 3 or more. We can take an additional action, which I will of course use to shoot the Yetian observer again. So I'll use the Derringer. I'm shooting 5 versus 4. And it's a minus 1, so this guy is dead. And forced after monster enemy is defeated, this guy goes into the victory display. And we only have to face the Mask Hunter for now. And that's Winifred done. Quite a turn there, and we'll go to Stella. Stella moves here. And I think Winifred can tank that guy, so I'll just move to the ritual site. So there are 4 clues here. And forced after the end of the round, if there are fewer than 2 clues per investigator on ritual site, add clues to it until it has 2 clues per investigator on it. And if an investigator enters the ritual site, we advance. So shuffle the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck. Discard cards from the top of the encounter deck until 1 enemy is discarded. 2 enemies if there are 3 or more players in the game. Spawn each discarded enemy at the ritual site. No. Well, we just shuffle this deck. So, yeah, we moved. Let's see which enemy Stella gets. Hopefully it's not that anything too difficult. Yeah, well, it's a Grave Eater, so we're fine with that. We can just kill it next turn. And it's engaged with Stella. I will test for Frozen in Fear. 3 versus 3. It's a 0, so we get rid of this Frozen in Fear just in time. So now we have a new Act 3. So spend 1 clue, test willpower 3 or agility 3. If you succeed, place 1 clue on this act. If there are 2 clues per investigator on this act, advance. So I think we need to grab those clues, then we have to test to. Yeah, because we have to spend the clues. Enemy face, the Masked Hunter hits Wini for 2 damage. and this Grave Eater hits us for 1 damage and 1 horror. And we have to discard 1 card at random from our hand. So we lose the other Derringer, that is totally fine. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Oh no, yeah, we still need to do the upkeep. So we draw a card, we get pickpocketing and 1 resource. And we draw a card, we get Will to Survive, which is really nice, and we gain 1 resource. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another Doom, so we are at 3 Doom of 5. Stella's encounter card is Disciple of the Devourer. So we must place 1 Doom on the Disciple and also 1 of our clues to our location. We have no clues, so we'll just spawn the enemy over here. And place 1 Doom on the enemy. Winifred's card is Umordhoth's Breath Test, willpower 5. For each point you fail by, you must either choose 1 choose and discard a card at random from your hand or take 1 damage and 1 horror. Well, we can't boost it in any way, so we'll test the 1 versus 5. It's a minus 1, so we fail by 5, so we discard 2 cards and we have to take 3 damage and 3 horror, which is quite nasty. So we are 1 away from getting defeated by horror and 3 away by damage. Well, that is the Mythos phase done. Let's go to the investigation phase. I think we will start with Winifred. So Wini will evade. I'm evading 5 versus 2. It's an Elder sign. Well, we didn't commit any cards, so we can't pull any cards back, but the Mask Hunter is evaded. Second action, Wini will move here. Last action, we'll spend 2 resources to investigate. And we are investigating 5 versus 3. It's a minus 1. We get 1 clue. And that is Winifred done. Stella's turn. I think for our first action, we'll shoot the at the ghoul. We are shooting 5 versus 2. It's a plus 1. The ghoul is defeated. Second action, Stella will investigate 2 versus 3. It's a minus 1, we fail, we get an extra action. We'll play Live and Learn, we'll test again. Now we're testing 4 versus 3. And I'll commit the Rabbit's Foot, so 5 versus 3. It's a cult, it's a minus 2, place 1 Doom on the nearest enemy. The nearest enemy is the Masked Hunter, but we still get the clue. I'll investigate again. Actually, I'll play the Flare, so it gets exiled, and we'll search our deck. Top 9 cards. And we put an ally asset into play, and we'll put Lita Chandler in play, just in case. So these are gone. Last action, I'll try to move one clue onto the act. So we are testing willpower 3. It's a minus 2, we fail. So that is our turn, enemy phase. Nothing happens, upkeep, mass hunter readies. And we go to, well, we are in the upkeep, so we draw a card, we get a leather jacket, and neither rain nor snow for Stella. So that is that turn. Oh yeah, we get resources. At the end of the round, we add two clues here. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We have, when we add a doom, we have 5 doom in play. So the agenda advances. So in player order, each investigator must test willpower 6. Each investigator who fails must search the collection for a random basic madness weakness and add it to his or her hand. I'll test with Stella first. It's an elder sign. I'm still failing, so I'll just fail it, and I'll heal 1 damage and 1 roar. So Stella gets a madness, and then we test for Winnifred. It's a 0, and we still fail. So I'll grab my madness weaknesses and be right back. Okay, so let's shuffle my pile of basic weaknesses with the madness trait and draw one at random for both of the investigators. So Stella gets unstable odd block, unspeakable odd blockers. That's just fine. Then Winifred gets kleptomania. This isn't that that nice. So now Winifred needs to start stealing stuff. Okay, well, let's continue. So we'll pull our encounter cards. Oh yeah, let's resolve this. So we are at the agenda 3A. Vengeance awaits. Fourth, when his agenda advances, if there are investigators are at Act 1, put the set aside ritual site in play and spawn the set aside Umordhoth there. If the investigators are at 2 or 3, discard all enemies at ritual site and spawn the set aside Umordhoth. So yeah. So encounter card for this turn for Stella is Corpse Taker, farthest empty location. This is the only empty location left. Then Winifred's card is Acolyte of Umordhoth, and it spawns engage with Winifred. Okay, so let's start. And I think we'll start with Winifred. I will evade 5 versus 2 the Acolyte. It's a skull, it's a number of monster enemies in play. There are 2 different monster enemies, so we still pass, and we won't pass enough for the lucky cigarette case, but this is evaded. second action, I'll just change this sleeve so we can shuffle this back into Winifred's deck. So that's the second action. And last action, I will try the agility test to move the clue onto the act deck. Oh yeah, and Stella spent one clue and failed, so the clue is gone, unfortunately. So we are testing 5 versus 3. Okay, minus 5. So we fail and we lost that clue. That sucks. Well, that's Winifred done. We'll go to Stella. I'll investigate with Stella. I'll use neither rain nor snow. I'm investigating 5 versus 3. It's a minus 1. We get one clue. And I think I'll shoot the acolyte. Yeah, I'll shoot the acolyte with the derringer. It's a minus 3. I'll take 1 damage because there's a monster enemy at our location. I'll just take it on Vita. And I have a plus 1 actually, so I hit and I'll deal 1 extra damage, so this guy is defeated. I forgot about Lita. And so I I think I messed up the action. So first action was to test the moving of the clue. Second action was to shoot, and I hit because of the Aglita. I kill it last. Well, I think I'll just try to investigate. Yeah, we fail. Okay, we get an extra action. I'll just use it to draw a card. We get the scrapper. So that is the investigation phase done. I think I may have messed up the order where we still failed with everything. So enemy phase, the masked hunter moves here and create the most clues. I'll just engage with Stella because Wini would die to the attacks quite soon. So Stella takes 2 damage. This guy actually got 1 doom at the start of the mythos and moves here. And yeah, next turn it will just generate more doom. Okay, well, we go to upkeep. We draw a card with Winifred and Stella. And we gain resources. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom and counter card for this turn for Stella is Rotting Remains. We'll just test it 3 versus 3. It's an elder sign. I'll just pass it. And Winifred gets Grave Eater, so it engages Winifred. I think we're just waiting for Umordhoth to spawn so we can beat Lita to it. I'll start by evading the Grave Eater with Winifred, 5 versus 2. It's a match 1, we can trigger the secret case. And this is evaded. Yeah, let's just put it there. And then I'll engage the masked hunter and I'll evade the Mask Hunter. I'll commit the Pickpocket and the Derringer to the evade test. I'll draw a card. And we evade. So the Mask Hunter is also evaded. And then Stella will investigate. I'll commit Sharp Vision to the test. Investigating. Oh yeah. I will play Will to Survive this turn. So I don't have to test. I'm not pulling any tokens, so first action Sharp Vision succeeds by two or more. We get two clues, and the following actions, I'll just move these clues here. Because I'm willpower 3 against 3, so I succeed because I don't have to pull any tokens. So we are halfway there. Enemy phase, this guy will generate one extra doom, and these guys ready at the upkeep. We draw a card for Winnifred and for Stella. And we gain resources. And that is that, and we replenish this location. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. I think this guy would have had extra doom. Okay, so unfortunately we are at 5 doom, so Umordhoth spawns here. It's massive. So we take the encounter cards. Each investigator must discard one card at random from their hand. This can't be discarded. So Stella loses a player. That is fine. And Winifred loses. Was a sneak by. Okay, and Winifred's card is Offer of Power. We have to draw two cards and add two doom. So these dooms are removed. Just add two doom here. That is the mythos phase, so we are at the investigation phase. Action, if you control Lita Chandler, it's only after her you throw Lita to Umordhoth in order to spare your lives. So I'm pretty sure we have no way of defeating Umordhoth anyway else at the current board state, so I'll take attack of opportunity from Umordhoth. 3 damage. And 3 horror. And I'll discard Lita. Or feed it to Umordhoth. So we get resolution 3. In your campaign log, record that the investigator sacrificed Lita Chandler to Umordhoth. Each investigator suffers 2 physical trauma and 2 mental trauma, as the mere sight of Umordhoth has taken its toll on his or her body and mind. The guilt over sacrificing Lita forever haunts your memory. Each investigator must search the collection for a random madness and add it to his or her deck. Each investigator earns experience equal to the victory X value of each card in the victory display, and it is 2. The investigators have survived, but their actions weigh heavily on their consciousness. So, just for the fun of it, let's see what madness cards the both of them got. So Stella got in unspeakable out curiosity. And Winifred got draw the sign. Okay, so we managed to stop Umordhoth by feeding Lita Chandler to it. So it's not a pure win, but at least we survived. So that was a return to the Night of the Zealot with Stella Clark and Winifred Habbamock. So I really liked playing both of these investigators. I think Stella's fail and get benefits playstyle is really intriguing, and of course Winifred's high agility and commit tons of cards to test is really entertaining to play, at least for me. But I think I won't ever again play with these starter decks with these investigators, so I'll just start building up decks for them. But hope you enjoyed the playthroughs of these two investigators, so thanks for watching, and until next time.